Hey, Redophiles. I was doing a free show at a bar in Spring Lake, Michigan, and it was packed. Because free crowds can get a little bit rowdy, they opened the show by warning everyone about my heckler clips, and they put special signs on each table warning people to keep their mouth shut. I was in the middle of telling a joke about how I don't like most people, and how Darwinism is a really good thing. Not only did someone interrupt, but he did something else I can't stand. He said empty words that mean absolutely nothing.
I don't think we need that person.
I want to know how you really feel.
You want to know how I really feel? Okay, well you came to a show where I talk for an hour, so you'll fucking learn. Are you surprised at how this is working right now?
I'm just waiting.
You're just waiting. Okay. It didn't seem like you were waiting, it seemed like you ran out of patience. The other people who kept silent, they were fucking waiting.
You're running out of money for shots.
You're running out of money for shots. Okay, well, how well you do at your job is not my concern. If you don't have enough money, that's on you, buddy. That's not on me. The tickets were already free. I can't help you any further. There was no cover charge. I already got you because I'm fucking quicker, and that's why you should shut up and let me do this.
I like it.
You like it. Okay, so did they until this little exchange. I never got that, tell us how you really feel. That's the most empty fucking sentence. It's a very empty sentence, because that's what I was in the middle of on purpose. So basically, what you mean to say is, hey, you're really passionate about this subject, and it's making me uncomfortable, because I'm not passionate about things myself.
True.
Is that where you were going?
True.
Okay. Well, next time, use those words instead.
I learned something today.
Okay, good. So did everybody else. Don't fucking talk to me. That's what I learned. It's funny, I have a bit of a reputation that they announced before the show as someone who murders hecklers. And even that, you're like, I don't know if it's true. Let's see what happens. Let's poke a bear and see if it eats me. Okay. Here's the thing. I can't tell you how I really feel, because I was in the middle of a passionate bit, and then you interrupted it. Now if I go back in, it seems ungenuine. And that's what fucking happens when you interrupt someone. What did you want to have happen when you said that to me?
I
want to
laugh.
You want to laugh? Okay. And you weren't?
Yes.
You weren't laughing.
I was trying.
You were trying, but you were failing. Yes. The signal telling your brain it was funny was trying to get to your mouth. And he was like, I want to laugh. And your mouth was like, nah. Instead, I'm just going to say, tell us how you really feel, like it fucking means anything.
Yes.
Okay, so you weren't laughing at a free show.
Yes.
And you didn't realize you could leave. The shots were going good. No, you ran out of money for shots. You already told us that earlier. So let me see, you weren't enjoying the show, you were out of money to buy things, and then you're like, I'll just stay here. You're a bad decision maker, sir. Did you know who you were coming to see when you came to see me?
No, I did not.
No? You're a bad decision maker, sir. Well, how about this? I'm going to tell all of them how I really feel. If it makes you uncomfortable, you can go. If you're okay with it, tell your mouth to fucking laugh. And we'll see how it goes. Okay? So my point is, I don't like people. Those of you who didn't laugh at that earlier, now you fucking know why. Stop saying things that mean nothing. That's what I'm talking about. No, that's what I was talking about. You weren't saying shit. You said one thing and it meant nothing. You were like, let me say, do you also say working hard or hardly working? Where the fuck do you learn to talk? What do you do for a living, sir?
I own a building business.
You own a building business. You have employees who have to listen to you or they get fired?
We just 1099.
You just 1099. Okay, wait, you own your own business and you can't afford shots. That's even funnier. You ain't building shit, sir. How much are shots?
$3.
$3? Fuck, man. I know Michigan's faced some hard times, but holy shit. How many did you have?
Three.
Okay.
I know, hold on, I know it gets real confusing after three. Four's next, after that's five.
I want the nine.
How many did you have?
Probably nine.
Probably nine. Okay, that means six. Legitimately, how many did you have? Those others at the table that are sitting watching your friend twist in the wind, help me out.
Ask my waitress.
What?
Ask my waitress.
No, I'm not gonna bother her with your asinine shit. I'm gonna ask your friends. Wait, hold on a second. Did you really say two?
He said two.
I saw two.
Hold on, how many did he have?
Two.
Two? You broke drunk motherfucker. First of all, you lost count after two, which is amazing. Second of all, you own your own building business and you ran out of money at $6. Eight if you include tip. Wait a second, this guy. $6.50 if you include tip.
Right, 20%?
Probably 20%. Okay, that's $1.20. I'm just trying to help you out because you're not going to get there on your own. But I'm just telling you how I really feel.
Thank you for subscribing. And don't forget to check out my new series, Afterburn, where I give you the behind the scenes on some of my most popular clips. If you want to watch it, there's a playlist in the video's annotations right now. If you want to come to a live show, instead of asking in the comments, hey, when are you going to be in this city, just go check out my calendar. Coming up soon, I'm in Los Angeles, Tampa, Nashville, Indianapolis, Louisville, Dayton, Detroit, Baltimore, Boise, New York City, and a whole lot more. Grab your tickets now, and I'll see you there.